Here, in unit 1, we are going to start with soil structure. So why is it basically necessary to study the different types of soil structures that are available? Let us see. If you see a soil, any type of soil, so the structure of the soil is formed because of the different arrangements of particles. Okay, there are n number of particles in the soil. So they have a specific geometrical arrangement with respect to each other. Okay, and different types of soils, they shall contain different structures. It means size, shape, orientation of each single particle. Okay, structure means shape, size and orientation of each particle. And since they are different in nature from each other, we will have different types of soil structures. Okay, so it is not possible that these soil structures, they are connected to each other 100%. No, there has to be some gap in between the two soil particles. Technically we call it, each particle we call as grain. Okay, grain, grain. So in between the two grains, there is some void. It may be larger void, it may be lesser void, depending on its size, shape and orientation. Okay, so the voids in soil particles, since they are there, so there will be passage of air, okay, as well as there will be passage of water through these voids. So since there is air passing through these voids, as well as water is passing through these voids, so it is going to affect the engineering properties of soil. So what are different engineering properties of soil or index properties of soil? We shall see that in the next session. Okay. So in order to study these engineering properties, we need to understand what are the different types of soil structures are there. Okay, different types of soil structures. So there are 5 to 6 different soil structures. First is single grain structure. Second is honeycomb structure. Third is flocculated structure. Then dispersed structure. Then coarse grained skeleton. And last is clay matrix structure. So we shall just go through this, each type of soil structure one by one. Single grained soil structure. What is this? If you see, there are these different grades. If you see this image on left hand side, here you can see each grain is of different size, shape, its orientation is different. Some particles or some grains are placed horizontally, some are placed vertically, some are inclined. Okay, and the major force acting on each grain is the gravitational force. If you see, this is the real picture of a single grain structure. Okay, and this is a graphical representation of the same soil structure. So what happens here, this type of soil or this kind of structure, it is found in coarse grained soil. What is coarse grained? It means the coarse particles are coarse in nature, they are not fine. Okay, and because these are coarse grained structures, so such type of soils become cohesionless soil. What is cohesionless soil? It means it is smooth. Okay, so if you see gravel and sand, these are the two types of soils which are usually cohesionless soil. Okay, and they will have such type of single grain structure. Okay, so you can visualize what is a gravel or a sand type of soil is. usually sea sand is there, or the sand that is used for construction purposes, that particular sand is the cohesionless soil. Okay. So here, gravity is dominant force on each grain. So what will happen because of this? These single grains, because of gravity, they will acquire some equilibrium position because of gravity. Okay. And they will achieve or acquire some different position in the soil structure. And they will settle down. Okay. Because of gravitational forces. And when such structure is formed, that particular soil structure is known as single grain structure. Okay. So each soil structure will have certain voids. They will be more or less, okay, they will be varying. So voids ratio is different. Depending on the arrangement of particles in the soil deposition, okay, it means depending on whether the void kept between the two particles is more or less, it will again classify the single grain soil structure as loose soil structure and dense soil structure. Now, what is loose soil structure? Let us see. Loose soil structure means by default, the voids are more. Okay. So the voids between the two particles will be more. And it is going to increase volume of voids. Correct. Void ratio and permeability also. It means if the voids are more, if the gap between the two particles is more, it means more amount of air shall pass through those voids and water shall also pass in more quantity through these voids. So since air and water are passing in large quantity, permeability of such soil structure will also be more. Okay. If this is less, then it is exactly opposite. Okay. It will be exactly opposite. So we are talking about dense soil structure. So if dense soil structure is there, voids must be less. Correct. The gap between the two particles must be less. Volume of voids will be less. Void ratio is less. Permeability is also less. And since in dense soil structure, compressibility is also less. What is compressibility? Since the voids are less, the settlement of that particular soil layer will also be less because the gap between the two particles itself is less. If you apply any pressure on this soil structure, it is going to get compressed by less amount because gap in between the two particles is less. Okay. So low compressibility and high shear strength. Okay. Low compressibility and high shear strength. These two characteristics of this particular single grain soil structure will be suitable for engineering structures. Okay. Now we shall see loose soil structure, exactly opposite of dense. Higher voids ratio, higher volume of voids, higher permeability. Okay. All these properties will be more for loose soil structure. And because of this, the loose soil structure will become unstable. I hope you are understanding. Since these properties are more, hence loose soil structure becomes unstable. It means if you are going to construct any building on this type of soil structure, the building shall be unstable. Okay, because if you apply static load, the building may get collapsed. Okay, so if you apply earthquake loads, vibrations, to such loose soil structure, what will happen? The grains will settle down and they will ultimately reduce the voids ratio. It means the gap between the two particles, where it is here large because of vibration, it will get reduced and there will be considerable settlement of soil in case of loose soil structure. Okay. So here, single grain soil structure, the same things I have just put here in some theoretical part. There is some more information on single grain soil structure. Loosest state, we just saw the loose soil structure here. What happens is single grain soil structures, they are deposited under gravitational forces. But here, position of particles after settling also matters. So if you apply certain load here, the voids ratio is going to get reduced. So if we assume that all the particles are spherical in nature, like here shown in the diagram. So here, what will happen here? The maximum void ratio takes place. It means void ratio is 0.9. So if this voids ratio is more, it means the gap between the two particles is more. And when they are positioned in cubical or in manner. Okay, this is the worst case scenario in the loosest state. Okay. Another state is the densest state, we can say, where the gap between the two particles is minimum. How much minimum? So much less as voids ratio goes to 0.35. So if this state is achieved, if the densest state is achieved, it means the grains, soil grains, they are positioned in diagonal packing manner as shown in figure. Okay. And when this is the state, it is known as densest state, where voids ratio is 0.35. And worst case, voids ratio is 0.9. Okay. It means what? It means that void ratio of single grain particles is in between 0.35 to 0.9. Okay. Now, when we have to use such soil for civil engineering structures or civil engineering purposes, then void ratio of the soil should be minimum, or in other words, dense soil is preferable. Okay, dense soil is preferable. It means you should have densest state of soil structure. Densest state of soil structure if you want to construct any engineering structure. Loose soil, it is very unstable and it cannot withstand any vibrations or shocks. So I hope the single grain type of soil structure is clear to you all, friends.